Are you in the process of building a new home but still deciding what type of insulation to use? Hi, I'm John, an estimator with RetroFoam of Michigan. Let's discuss and compare the most common types of insulation used in new build homes today. Cellulose, fiberglass, and spray foam. Cellulose is most commonly found in the attic and sometimes in the walls. It can be either a loose fill or blown in material and is primarily made of recycled newsprint or denim. Over time, cellulose can settle up to 20%, can shift to one side of the attic, and won't create an air seal on its own. This is the primary cause of high energy bills and other problems. Cellulose is also a dirty material that can increase the amount of dust in your home. If using in the attic or walls of your new home, you should take the extra time and effort to first air seal the area before applying the cellulose. Fiberglass can be used in all areas of the home, including the attic, the walls, crawl spaces, and the rim joist. It is made of extremely fine glass fibers and can be made in rolls, often called batts or loose fill. Fiberglass is made to be placed between stud cavities or floor joists, but also allows for major airflow, leading to potential problems like uncomfortable rooms, drafts, cold floors, and high energy bills. It is the least expensive insulation material, but often causes the most problems down the road. Spray foam is made from organic chemical compounds obtained from petroleum extracts and can be used in all areas of the new home. Foam insulation not only insulates, but is an air barrier material that creates a seal against air movement, reducing energy bills and adding comfort. Because of its superior benefits, it is the most effective option for solving insulation-related problems in the home. But it comes with the highest initial cost. Over time, the total investment is actually much less than other insulation materials as it lasts the life of the home and provides monthly savings on energy bills. There is another option that some contractors may suggest called flash and batt, a combination of spray foam and fiberglass batt insulation. This is when a flash of closed cell spray foam is sprayed first for an air seal and then fiberglass batts are placed over it. This hybrid model could work if done properly. However, many contractors suggest this method to cut costs and apply the closed cell foam at less than the 2 inches required to create an air seal, causing problems in the future. So which insulation type is best for your new home? That's really up to you to decide. If you're building the new home of your dreams, this decision should not be taken lightly. Thanks for watching, and head on over to our Learning Center to learn more about insulating your new build home.